Hello, namaste, welcome or welcome back to Greet Arrow. So how are you? I hope you're doing good. I hope it's an amazing day. So the topic for today is the veil is thin. Messages from the higher realms on what you are not seeing. So that's the topic. Remember, these are general readings, so take what resonates and leave the rest behind, guys. And these are timeless readings as well. So whenever you watch, this reading might have a message for you. So as you can see, there is the images of eyes. So close your eyes, relax, trust your intuition and choose a eye that calls to you intuitively. 1, 2, 3, take your time, pause the video. The timestamps will be in the description box. I'm gonna see you in your Namaste, group number one. This is the image that you have chosen. Let's see, what is the message? The veil is thin. Messages from your higher realms on what you are not seeing right now. Okay, your problems will be solved if you are very, very clear with your communication. So for many of you, you are not saying the truth, and that's why there are issues. So for example, if we go to a doctor, right, sometimes we hide something. And when we hide, the proper diagnosis cannot be done. Like that only. Don't hide anything. Be very, very clear what you expect, what you want. Because if you are hiding something and not saying it clearly, this can lead to an issue in your life later. Okay? For some of you, that's the message. So right now, again, when you are applying for a job, right? Don't lie anything. Just say what you your experiences. Don't put anything that you are not experienced about. So otherwise, it will cause issues. So clear communication, what you know, who you are, the truth is needed. And when you're doing that, if there is an issue, the issue will be solved if you're very clear. Again, going to a doctor, if you're hiding something, you're not going to get the proper diagnosis. And when you don't get the proper diagnosis, you're not going to get rid of the disease, right? You will not heal. Like that only when you are clearly communicating with the doctor and then you're saying everything that needs to be said, the doctor is going to give you the perfect diagnosis. They will diagnose the perfect thing and you're getting the perfect medicines, and because of it you will heal. So that's something I'm getting. It's a metaphor here. So clear communication is the key for you guys right now. Whatever you're doing in your life, if you are doing business or if you are looking for a new job, whatever it is, clear communication, be authentic, be honest. Okay, so clear communication is the key for anything in your life right now. And you're not seeing that currently. Maybe you're hiding something. Maybe you're not saying what you feel completely. Maybe you're not expressing somehow, somewhere. So clear communication is required. So sometimes when we are children, you know, we don't communicate what is the cause to our parents. Rather, what we do is we express anger. So instead of expressing anger, you need to voice out what is the issue that is bothering you. It's not the time to hide. So here, with clear communications, things are not going to be so hard as you think. That's what you're not seeing. With clear communication, you will find the solutions. Actually, things are not going to get worse. It will get better. That's what you're not seeing. So let's see what's the message here, group number one. Up. Wow. Okay, look up here. Divine is with you. Again, we are talking about the veil is thin, the mess, you know, what you're not looking, messages from the higher realms. And here you are up. You can look up your higher realms, your spirit guides, or all are protecting you. They are telling you that they are giving you messages. They're giving you the messages. They're giving you the signs, but you're not looking up. Somehow, because of the fear, you're so caught up in the fear. Or maybe you feel like you cannot share this thing. That's why you're just hiding it, and it's not making you feel good. Something that you're hiding, it's not making you feel good here. And once you release that, once you let it out, you will be safe. You will be protected, actually. Actually, it will take that burden from you. You know, sometimes some children lie because they feel like that their parents will react in a bad way. And that's the reason sometimes children lies. They don't know that if they share it with their parents, actually they will get the help. But they think that they will not receive the help. Actually, their parents will be mad at them. So they just assume things. Yeah, that's the energy I'm getting here. Sometimes we, because of our own assumptions, because we feel we make it in our head and we see the worst case scenarios, so we don't communicate properly. Rather, what we do is keep to ourselves and hide from it, right? Again, a person, right, in a relationship, they're hiding certain emotions and feelings. And what happens is, when we do keep on doing, the other person might not know what you want because you're not clearly communicating, and relationship is not going to go the way because you will not be happy. And you are thinking that if you communicate that things will get worse, but no, things are not going to get worse, it's going to get better. That's what you're not looking here. And look up, your spirit team is with you, helping you in this journey, right? Helping you to release whatever needs to release. You don't have to hide anything anymore. It's time to communicate. It's time for that open communication here. You're protected. You're safe. Things are going to look up, right? Once you release this thing, once, you know, something is there that you're hiding it. And you don't like hiding it. You want to express it. But because of the fear, you're not expressing it. Because you feel like things will be very bad. But it's the actual opposite that's going to happen, and things will look up. You will actually see the light. Things will move forward. So that's what the message is here. So let's see, what are you not seeing here? The wheel is thin. Hanged man. Yeah, you're again the hanged man. You're feeling stuck here because it's in reverse. You're not seeing the other perception, right? You're not seeing the truth actually. You're focusing on your fears. Again, when the hangman comes, it's actually a realization that we have. Hangman is a very good card actually. We see things from different angles. Here you're not seeing things from different angles. And that's the thing. You're not seeing the best case scenario. Rather, you're seeing the worst case scenario. You're feeling the fear. And that's why you're hiding things. And that's why you're feeling stuck. Maybe because it's related to some traumas of yours, that's why you feel like you cannot express yourself. Maybe this person will leave me. You're making all those assumptions here. And here, your spirit team is telling you to let go of all the assumptions and just clearly communicate. That's all they want. Things, half of the problem, most of the problem will solve by your clear communication. And things will look up. Yeah, look, we have this Two of Swords energy here. Stuckness, it feels like you're thinking something, you know, you want to express something, but you're expressing something else. You're not expressing your clear emotions. That's what it feels like. Because you are so afraid. What if this goes wrong? What if that goes wrong? So you're not expressing the true person you are. Rather, you're expressing someone that you think that other people will like, right? Because you're so afraid to say the truth, so you become someone else that you are not, and that's not making you happy. And here you don't have to do that. Here you don't have to do that. You can openly communicate your truth. And whatever happens, when you communicate the truth, you will see it very clearly that things are only going to get better actually. Maybe that thing will not go. You know, maybe you're, again, I see that maybe for some of you, it's in a job that you haven't. I told the example of the tiredness. That's the perfect example I'm getting here. Again, in a job, you lied and you don't know how to do the work. Instead of worrying, instead of learning, you cannot. You just need to express that I don't know that. Yes, maybe for some of you, the job might go, but you will receive something better. That's the thing. That's what you're not seeing here. Things will look up. So if you are burning in that fire, you will just burn. Again, the guilt will eat you. Because you're hiding something. It will eat you in a way. It will not make you happy. Your mental health will not be that great. So it's better you have that clear communication. Yes, think, look, we have the Eight of Wands. Look, the Sun. Again, as I told here, once you start communicating, things will look up. Things will move forward. Again, I will go with the example of the diagnosis. Once you share the truth, this is my issue, this I did. Because of the shame, because of guilt, you were not expressing it. Something, right? Sometimes we have that thing. Sometimes we hide something. Because we feel like it's not that good to share that. It's maybe in the childhood we were told that we shouldn't share that with anyone. So maybe you thought that you cannot share that with the doctor. But once you share, they know exactly what needs to be done. They know exactly what is the issue, root cause, and they will find the solution. Like that, only your solution will come with clear communication. So don't hide anything. Because once you say, you express the Sun, you will move forward, the momentum will build, things will move forward for you guys. That's the message here. So let's see what else. And you will not be in this Hangman energy. You will clearly see, the reason why I was feeling like that, because I was thinking of all the worst case scenarios and I was not able to express my authentic side, and that's the only reason things were not moving forward for me. So clear communication, no hiding, nothing. If you are feeling stuck in a situation, the answer that you're not seeing is clear communication. So let's see what else. The reason why you are not expressing, it's because of your childhood. You need to understand that sometimes some patterns that we take from childhood, we use in our adult life. And your spirit is telling you it's because of that you're feeling that you cannot express yourself. So you can express yourself. You have the freedom to express yourself. You don't have to hide it anymore. Again, I'm just getting this example. When we are very small children, right? We don't know. But sometimes some young person can take advantage of us. And even though they are taking advantage of us, they tell that it's bad, you shouldn't share. And the child thinks that they are bad, right? Instead of understanding that this person was bad, the adult person was bad, the child takes on themselves, thinking that they are doing something bad. That's not true, isn't it? Like that only. Something that has happened in the past, you think that you have done the bad and that's why you're hiding it. That's not the case at all. And that's why your spirit team is telling you to clearly communicate. Because things are not as you think. As a small child thinks that that child has done some mistake, but is it? No. But once they communicate to their people, if they tell their parents right away, the parents can take action. And then the kid will understand that it was not his problem or his her problem, right? So like that only, something from your past you're taking on, thinking that it's you are the one who made mistake, because maybe you were, gaslight, or maybe you were manipulated, but that's not the case. So don't hide, express. Yes, you need to trust your intuition, but you are not trusting your intuition. Your intuition is saying to have, I feel like you are intuitively feeling that you need to communicate this thing. But at the same time, the logical mind will come and tell that, this is not something that you should do, you shouldn't express. Yeah, the fear will take over, the fear is taking over. And your spirit team is telling you, don't let the fear take over. Trust your own gut, trust your own intuition. Express yourself. You don't have to be in this Two of Swords energy. You don't have to be in confusion. You don't have to be in conflict with your heart and mind, right? Your heart is telling, again, with the Two of Swords, your heart is telling something and your mind is telling something. Your heart is telling you, yes, I need to express that. I need to express that. Again, another example, you're in love with someone, right? and you want to express that. Your heart is telling you to express, but your mind is telling, no, we have been rejected in the past, right? We have been rejected in the past. Now also we will be rejected. It was, again, I'm feeling, I'm not that good enough, I'm not that good looking. You know, all those things that we think, because of it, we don't express. That's the exact thing I'm seeing here. And as I told, most of your problems will end with clear communication. Yes, don't be worried about the outcome. Don't be worried about the results. Why don't you communicate? That's what your spirit team is telling you. So let's see. I really had a deja vu moment. I'm not even kidding, because I felt like I have done this reading before. I don't know why that feeling. Maybe for some of you, you will have a deja vu moment like that, where you feel like you have gone through this thing before. I don't know. I just felt that. Does this happen? This has happened to me. Yeah, it just felt like it has never happened like this. Oh God. Again, I just felt like that I've done this before. Interesting. So let's see the final tarot card, and then we'll move to the next set of cards. What is the message here? Yeah, look, Temperance. Again, you're not listening to your body. You're not listening to your mind, your heart, sorry. You're listening to that fear here. Once you balance yourself, again, you could look at the Hierophant. Meditation, reflection, yeah, trusting your intuition. That's what the most important thing is. Once you do that, you will have the courage to speak your truth. And once you express yourself, once you trust your intuition and take action towards it, things are going to move forward. There will be no confusion. There will be no conflict between your heart and mind here. So that's the message here. So let's see what else. The veil is thin. Message from the higher realms on what are you not seeing. A man holding a coin. For some of you, this can be like you're making assumption that this person doesn't like me and all. And that's why you're not expressing that. So maybe for some of you, yes, maybe this person likes you back. That is also there. If you, I'm getting that energy. For some of you, this can be related to your job as well. Maybe you want an opportunity, right? And people are applying for it and you want to do that. But at the same time, you're shying away from it. You're not sharing that because you feel like that you're not that good enough. Yeah, there is this feeling that you feel like you're not good enough, you're not worthy, that you cannot apply to these things. So you're keeping it hidden and you're doing what you think that other people like about you. It's also you making assumptions and you're not being authentic with your heart. Be authentic with your heart. You can make anything come true. But there is a man here. There is a man. For some of you, it's something that maybe you like a man, like a person. Maybe this is in your office. Or maybe you have a crush on this person and you want to express your feelings, but you're making assumptions. But once you express, things will move forward. So what your heart really wants, your heart doesn't want to hide. Your heart wants to express things. So express it. Don't let this mind, this fear come in between. Yeah. So be very clear. Communicate very clear and be okay. Communicate your heart. And if then you're not getting, you know what you want to hear, it's okay. You know, again, it feels like sometimes we hold on to things, we don't express, and it pains us so much. But once we let it out, you know, whatever the result is, it will not matter. You will be happy no matter what. You will be able to move forward because this thing, it's not going to bother you. That's what you're not seeing. So clear communication here. So let's see the final message here for you guys. From high realms, and what are you not seeing? Look, the two rings. For some of you, oh God. For some of you, this can be a new business opportunity that you want to do, you want to take action on, but your heart and mind is having a fight, okay? Is having a fight. No, you will not be able to do it. No one has done business in your family, blah, blah, blah. You're making assumptions, worst-case scenario, so you're not taking action, but your heart is telling you to express, right? That's how you're stopping yourself. And here, communicate properly wherever you want to take action on, who you want to communicate regarding this business, go ahead and do that. Do that. Again, with this rings, yes, for some of you, this can lead into a potential relationship. And yeah, again, Ace of Pentacles, it can, you know, you will start a new journey with this person. Things will move forward. Again, as I told, a diagnosis where you're shying away from, you have this guilt. So that's why you're not sharing the truth. But once the doctor knows the truth, they can give you the diagnosis and things will look better for you guys. You will heal. That's what the message is. Clear communication. Because once you clearly communicate, things will look up and you will get what you want. A start of a new thing. Make, you know, business idea, you're moving forward, that is giving you a lot of money, a relationship, a potential relationship. So yeah, so there is this confusion between your heart and mind. So for that meditation, for some of you, you are here to, you need to break free from your past with the Six of Cups, something related to your past, and that's why that's coming up, that's why you're not expressing, that's why you feel like you cannot do it. Let go of the past, release the past, balance your body, mind and spirit. And once you do it, once you express yourself clearly, once you communicate clearly, things are going to look up. There is no doubt here. Yeah. So that's all I received for group number one. Hope it made sense. Hope it resonated. If it did, give me a thumbs up. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Take care. Hello group number two, if you have chosen this image, the veil is thin, messages from higher realms on what you are not seeing, right? So if you look at it, there is a bird, there is this hummingbird here, and exactly, you're not seeing the joy that is going to come into your life. You're going through a major transformation. You're in the middle of the transformation, I feel like. You're in the middle path. You're not where you came from, but you're not either where you want to be, right? You're in this metamorphosis, like you're in the process of shedding the skin like the snake. And once the skin is shed, the joy, the transformation is going to be so awesome, right? You're going through a major transformation right now in your life. That's what I'm getting here. So if you're going through a period where there is a lot of confusion, this whole confusion piece will go. Maybe you're feeling a little bit stuck. Maybe you're not getting where you want to get, but you are clearing something out. You're clearing the clutter. It feels like you're clearing the dirt from the past. You're releasing the dust that we don't see. You know, sometimes even though we sweep our home, we clean our home, sometimes there will be a little dust, right? And that dust is being cleared. That's what you're not seeing. And that's why the things that you want is not happening. This is the only reason right now. So just be patient, group number two, because you're not seeing the joy that is coming, the happiness that you will be receiving very soon. I feel like that. So stay there, be in the present moment, enjoy your life right now, because things are going to get better. There is something much better coming your way, and you will be able to reach where you want to reach. So right now you're in this middle path. Enjoy that middle path. Be patient, okay? The joy, the happiness, it's all coming. Universe is telling you that. That's what you're not seeing, the joy. You're feeling a little bit struggle. You're feeling like, why I'm doing so much of work? Why I'm not getting there? You will. It's something that needs to be released. So this is the time for you guys to work on yourself. And whenever certain emotions, certain triggers come up, acknowledge that and release that. So you can clear this little bit dust that is left. That's why things are going to speed up for you guys. The joy, there is a lot of happiness coming here, group number two. That's what you're not seeing here. Okay, so let's see for group number two. The veil is thin, messages from higher realms on what you're not seeing. Your intuition is really, really very strong also. I feel like you know that things will happen for you guys. You will manifest. You have this feeling. But then too, when you're not seeing the result, there is a little bit of disappointment. I get it. Yeah. So maybe for some of you, having goosebumps right now, because I feel like I have. So maybe this is a strong message here. Okay. Right. Oh, look again, the right. You know, right. And it feels like you have been writing what you want to manifest. You've been writing your goals every day, maybe. You have been working towards your goal. You're having a plan. You're working towards it. I feel like that. And yes, this all things that you have been writing, it's going to come true. It's going to come true. So keep on working, keep on taking action. Because things are going to be better than you expect. It's just a matter of time. Okay? And again, write. Maybe for some of you, you are not seeing that you're a good writer, maybe. Yeah. You have that ability, you have that skill. Maybe you don't know. Maybe right now when I'm saying, you'll be like, no, I don't have that skill. But you are going to find about it very soon. You are going to see that happening. Maybe you're not seeing that how good you are at writing. Maybe your handwriting is good. That can be the thing. For others, it's like you're very good at expressing, but very good with words. You're very talented in writing. You're very good storytellers. That is also something I'm seeing here. Maybe you don't see that about yourself. But mainly your manifestations, what you're manifesting, it's going to come true. You are right now in the middle path. But yes, you need to acknowledge that, right? You're not where you started, isn't it? So look back, acknowledge that, be grateful for that. Give that gratitude, okay? Keep on giving that gratitude, because through gratitude, you're going to achieve anything and everything in your life. So be patient, guys. Be in the present moment, because you're going to achieve whatever you want to achieve in your life. Don't get worried about your future goals. Don't get worried about the unknown. Don't get worried about the future. Just keep on going, guys. If you are feeling like you're in the middle of the sea in a boat and you don't know which direction you need to go, keep on going. Keep on going. Just enjoy that phase. Just enjoy that phase. That's what Spirit Team is telling you, because there is so much of good that is coming. You will be so happy. You will be so happy. Happiness is coming. That's what you're not seeing here. There are a lot of joy. Good luck is coming your way. So just focus on your goals. Only focus on it. Build that momentum. Do your work. That's it. And rest. Give it to Divine. Give it to Divine, guys. He will take care of it. So let's see. What else is the message here? What are you not seeing? The veil is thin. The message from the higher realms on what you're not seeing. Yeah, look, five of coins here. You're feeling left out in the cold right now. Look, again, it feels like some of your wishes are not coming true, right? You're trying so hard and you're like, oh my God, whatever I do, why my wishes are not coming true? Why? Again, right? With this five of coins, look at the light there is. You're not seeing the light. You're not seeing the joy, the happiness. Again, so for some of you with this five of coins, you have a big wish. You have a big wish. Maybe it's about your business. Maybe you have a goal that you're working towards, but things are not happening right now. With this five of coins, I can see that you're feeling left out and cold. You're feeling like things are not going. That's why I was talking about the middle path, right? You need to get out of that mindset right now. If you are feeling the lag, this is the time to get out of that mindset. And we have the number 9-9. This is going to end soon. This phase that you're feeling right now, the middle path, it's going to end soon. You will reach at the end of the tunnel. You will see the light, okay? Look, we have the beautiful nines. We have the 9 of cups and the 9 of coins. Both are the beautiful nines. You didn't get the 9 of swords and 9 of wands, right? You got the good, amazing nines. Maybe you're seeing 999, so you're at the end of the learning. You have, as I told, we human beings come here to learn something, right? Sometimes we need to understand certain patterns that we are doing is not good, right? And we have to end it. So maybe right now also, maybe there is this thinking, this limited thinking that you have. And I seriously feel that's the only reason why you're not getting this cup. Everything is lined, your goals, your desires, you're working towards it, keep on working, but have that faith. Faith is required here. The more you get disappointed, the more you get left out in cold, the more it was going to take time for you to get this abundance. Maybe for some of you, you want to have a business and you want to be self-employed, you want to make money like that, you have been working towards that, but things are not happening, right? But you're not where you started from, right? But yeah, sometimes instead of focusing on the prosperous thoughts, we focus on the lack. So how you are seeing money, how you feel about money, that's always very important. Do you feel like money is very hard to obtain? Do you feel like you have to do a lot of hard work for it? You know, sometimes the value that we give, the worth, you know, the worth, are you, do you feel like you're worthy? That is all the questions that you need to ask to yourself. Somehow, somewhere, you are becoming the obstacle here. That's why things are not moving forward. Okay, maybe you're focusing too much on your goals. Maybe you're focusing too much on the outcome as well. Unknown, yeah, focusing on the unknown, wanting to know everything, you know, how things will be in the future. So you need to expect good results, but don't be so much attached to it. Expect, write your goals every day, perform well, do what you can do today, and expect the best, but don't get attached to it. Once you get attached to it, that's when this five of coins comes. That's when the feeling of lack arises, and we don't want that feeling. You can change the feeling to a more better feeling whenever these kinds of feelings arise. That's what spirit is telling you. Don't dwell on that feeling. You know, we can change our vibration in 17 seconds. So whenever you're thinking that your goals are not moving forward, things are not happening, whenever you're getting into this negative state of thinking, if you're in this lack mindset, choose a better thought, next better thought that will make you good. Like you can look at the past. Oh, I did that at the past. In the past, this happened, right? Now also it will happen. Things will happen for me. I'm lucky. Like what good thoughts, you know, the thoughts that makes you feel like it's true. Not something that doesn't feel authentic. Choose the thoughts that makes you feel like, yeah, it's going to happen. Yeah, in the past it happened. This will happen. I came here. I'm right now in this. Yes, I have manifested a lot of goals in the past. Think about those things and feel those kinds of good energy, right? But I have to say, your goals, your wishes are definitely going to come true. If it's about a business, if it's about your self-development, definitely I see that you're going to grow. Again, this nine of coins energy is a very beautiful story here. In this, there was this person, he was a farmer or something. He was of a low caste or something like that, and he just fell in love with the princess, and the king was like, oh, this person is so hardworking, so let's just get married, make him married to his daughter. So they get married, and king gave him a lot of things as well, and this person really was having a very abundant life with the princess, right? And but this person was not telling everyone about the king gave him this thing, king gave him that thing, you know. So king's ego came up, and he's like, oh, he's not telling other people that I gave them this all money. That's why they are having an abundant life, you know. So the king, what he did is like took all the money from him, whatever he gave, and they were left with nothing. And then they had to move to another village or something like that. So they moved to another village, and then there they saw a fruit like this. And what happened is, like, with this one seed, he cultivated a lot of watermelons, and everyone was talking about this fruit. And then he grew his farm, and he made money, right? And then the king realized it was not because of him that this person made that abundance. It's because of his thinking, his work, all right? Like that only, yeah? That's the story here. So you have that capability to make things like this person made. You can build an empire by yourself, by your positive thinking. You have that much strength. So don't let these negative thoughts stop you, okay? And yes, whatever your wishes are, it's not too big. It's not too good to be true. You can make it come true. Even if it's a relationship, even if it's anything, you can. Okay? So your goals are coming true. But don't dwell in this five of coins energy. Don't feel like that your hard work will never pay off. You know, if you have those kinds of feelings, stop. Reflect. We have eight of wands. Again, it feels like eight of wands energy, five of cups. Whenever this fast move, you know, energies, you know, thinking patterns come, oh, I'm not doing this, things are not working. Whenever this disappointment come, look at yourself and yes, I'm feeling like this. This is not the reality. I need to let go of. I need to stop these feelings and I need to replace it with something that is better thought, right? So do that fast. Okay, anyways, things are going to move forward for you guys with this Eight of Wands, yeah? Things are going to happen. Your goals, your wishes, that's going to come true. That's what you're not seeing. Yeah, look, we have Eight of Swords. Look. Yeah, you're feeling like, nah, nothing. My wishes are not going to come true. Whatever I do, nothing is working out. Again, she is fully trapped in her thoughts. That's the only issue here, your thoughts. These are your thoughts that you need to let go of and work on your ideas, your creativity. And you can make anything come true. Again, we have Three of Swords as well. It feels like some of you are making your own pain by overthinking a lot of things. With this, that's what I'm really feeling here. Yeah. You need... We have the Death card as well, right? Once you take charge of your thoughts, right? Once you take, yes, in the past I failed, it's okay now. But I have come this far. Once you see what all things have been manifesting in your life, once you see the good in life, right, you will be able to let go of these things, you will be able to end these things, and you will get what you want here. So I really feel like for some of you, you're feeling very heartbroken because your wishes, your desires that you want, there is a lot of disappointment here. You have been working on your goals, you have been taking action, but things have not been moving forward the way you want it to move forward, right? And that's why there is a lot of fear-based energy. You need to stop those fear-based energy. And journaling will be very, very helpful for you guys at this time. So again, whenever you're seeing yourself dwelling in negative thoughts, in lack mindset, stop there and journal your emotions. Journal, write about it. And once you keep on writing, you will see, you can see like how you're thinking. And then you can choose, as I told you, can choose the next thought, you know, good thought that is good, that will make you feel good. So you can let go of the thoughts that makes us feel very bad. Okay, so yeah, this is all, I feel like this is something that you're thinking, that my future is not bright, I will not be able to have. So small disappointments are giving you a lot of pain. And here your spirit team is telling you what you're not seeing is this is not true. This thing that you want is going to come true, but you need to focus more on positive thinking, okay? And don't get too attached with the results. Have this detachment and just go with the flow. Go with the flow. Right now, that's what you need to do. Go with the flow. The more you focus on the results, you know, the more you will get heartbroken and the more you will feel trapped. We don't need that. So we need to stop those kinds of thinking and focus on the flow, being in the present moment, focusing only on your goals and try to grow that. Right? So that's what you don't have to overdo anything. You don't, and don't procrastinate as well. Just go with the flow. What you can do today, do it. And find gratitude. Like write 10 things that you're grateful for every day and focus on that thing. That's the energy that you need to create. And once you create that energy, the momentum will build and you will get what you want. Okay? So let's see. Yeah, again, it feels like a lot of overthinking, making up scenarios. Maybe for some of you, are taking other people's words also very, very seriously. Maybe there are someone around you who tells you that you're not good enough and you take them very seriously. Maybe you compare yourself with other people and that can cause a lot of heartbreak, yeah, because you feel like, oh, they just started this journey last month and I have been in this journey for years, but I have not gotten what they got. And so sometimes it can create a lot of pain, right? So don't do that. Stop doing all those things and just focus on your goals, your dreams. Don't compare. They might have a journey that we don't know, right? So yeah, so that's the message here. So the final message. Again, with a sword, I feel like fight these thoughts. Cut these thoughts fast. As soon as it comes, cut it. That's what spirit is telling you. Because this is not the time to dwell on those thoughts. Because this is the time where you're going to see your manifestations, right? You're going to get what you want. So just focus on the energy that you want to build, not on something that you don't want to build in your life, right? So let's see the final message. Look, we have seven. And again, it feels like you're cutting yourself through your own thinking. You're cutting yourself, your heart into two pieces because of your own thinking. Don't do that. Because look, we have the good fortune. We have, look, the four-leaf clover. It's there, the coins, the money, that whatever you want, it's there. It's in your vibration. It's in your energy. But these thoughts, that's what you need to let go of. Or maybe there is people around you who tell you that you cannot do this, you cannot achieve it. Let them go. Don't take their words seriously. But more I feel like it's your own energy, your own thinking pattern, like whatever I do, nothing comes true. So maybe you're not focusing too much on gratitude, rather you're focusing what's not working. So focus on what's working and be grateful for that. That's the message here. Once you do that, things are going to move forward here. Yeah. So be patient, and whenever you're having those kinds of thoughts, it's stop them. The thoughts that make us fearful, the thought that cut us into two pieces, right? That makes us so feel very bad, disappointed. Acknowledge where is that thought coming from. Oh, because I didn't get the result, that's why I'm feeling like that. Oh, maybe I'm comparing myself to this person, that's why I'm feeling like that. And understand that the cause, root cause of that thought, and change it to a better thought, right? So that's what you need to do here. So that's all the message from the higher realms for you guys for today. Hope it made sense. Hope it resonated. If it did, give me a thumbs up. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Hello, Namaste, group number 3. This is the image that you have chosen. Let's see, what is the message? The veil is thin. Messages from higher realms on what you're not seeing. Again, I'm just like, look at the rays, you know, that's coming here. I feel like when I saw this, I feel like a major breakthrough is coming. A breakthrough is at hand. That's what you're not seeing right now. And your vibration is very, very high. You are becoming one with the universe. Whatever you're doing, keep on doing it because it's working. It's really working. So keep on going the way you are going. Maybe you have a schedule now, you wake up at morning, you have a meditation practice, maybe you're doing something that is actually helping you to raise your awareness, your vibration. You're seeing your truth. Again, the purple color, I feel like your third eye and your crown chakra is very much open. You're very connected to the source. So whatever you're doing, keep on doing. I would say that because you're doing amazing. Your vibe. For group number 3, your vibration is very high. For some of you, your intuition, all you need to do is to trust your intuition because it's guiding you. You can really trust your intuition here. So let's see what else. A lot of knowledge is going to come your way, more wisdom, I see that. So whatever you're doing right now, do, because a major breakthrough is at hand. That's what you're not doing. Seeing, I think, there is a major breakthrough. So keep on doing what you're doing. We have the rejuvenation. Oh, you're healing. Look, for some of you with this mediumship card, you're someone who have the skill, like you have the gift to take the messages from the spirit and give it to the other people, right? Maybe your dreams are going to be very, very vivid, or it's already, maybe you're getting prophetic dream messages in your dreams. So whenever you feel like you need to call someone, give that message to someone, do that without any hesitation, because spirit is making you a channel in order to give the messages. As I told, you are very, very intuitive here. You're very intuitive and you are really rejuvenating. Releasing all the patterns right now, and that's why I'm seeing like a major breakthrough is hand. You're healing your body, mind and spirit right now. Your frequency is going to be high vibe. I see your upper chakras opening. You're opening your heart so you can receive. For some of you, I would recommend doing meditations in order to in order to open your crown chakra third eye, do meditations, guys, every day. If you are doing already, I feel like many of you are already doing it. Keep on doing, continue doing it. Continue doing whatever you're doing right now, because you're rejuvenating, you're healing, and a major breakthrough is at hand. Yes, you. For some of you, this breakthrough can be you finding something about yourself. That a gift. For some of you, you will be feeling like you have a gift. You will be finding that gift. For many of you, you are psychic. Maybe you didn't saw yourself like that, and that's what you're going to find. And maybe for some of you are not seeing that. You are a psychic. You are a medium in some way. So you don't have to pursue that thing, right? All you need to do is whenever you feel something, right? You feel like you need to give this message to someone, go ahead and do that. Do that. Don't hesitate. Okay? So let's see. What I'm seeing, like, you know, the spirit guides are telling you, you are going to understand something about yourself, your own potential. That's the breakthrough. It's something that is hidden in you. You're going to discover that. I don't know why I'm seeing, like, this lamp, the genie lamp. Again, sometimes it's in us. Everything is within us. Interestingly, we have this genie lamp. I just saw it in my third eye view, that, you know, I saw that, yeah, this lamp, and now I didn't see it here actually, and now it's here. So many genie lamps, and this person is confused what to take, and you will exactly know what is your lamp name. Yeah, you were confused, but now you know. So you are going to pick the lamp that is yours. Again, there is this, have you seen this Deal or No Deal? There was like one kind of a show in that they chose the bag or something like that. You know, money, I don't know why I'm getting that game. It feels like that. And you're choosing the correct box, which has a lot of money. Again, this is the breakthrough. You're finding something that will give you what you want, actually. That will rejuvenate you, that will make you so happy. Wow, I don't know, this Deal or No Deal. If you don't know, check. I think it's a game where there are a lot of models with one box suitcases, and then they have to say something like that, right? I don't know, but that's something I feel like. I'm feeling like you're getting very lucky as well. So let's see. What are you not seeing? Oh, wow, Two of Cups. This can be you aligning your body, mind and spirit. Your heart and your mind is aligned. And when it's aligned, we receive the guidance from the spirit. We are one with the universe. You're becoming one with the universe. You're becoming one with self. You're not feeling apart. You're becoming one. That's the energy. And that's the reason you will be getting all your wishes come true. That's what it feels like. For some of you, this can be like you're going to meet your soulmate, your other half. That's something I'm seeing, because you are going through a healing, so you're going to manifest the love of your life. But more, it feels like your body, mind and spirit is aligning. You're healing. That's what is happening here. That's what you're not seeing. Eight of Pentacles. Oh wow, we have the Ten of Pentacles. Oh God, look. Money, money, money. I don't know why I'm hearing that song. So as I told you, this game, you're going to this game. You're playing the game. You're one with the universe. You know which box you need to choose. You exactly know it. You're seeing it in your third eye. Yeah, this is the box. So you choose that box. And that has the money. Like, that's what the message is. That's what you're not seeing. You're going to become so lucky in your work, in your career, whatever you're working for. Look, she's working so hard. So something that you have been working really, really, really hard on, you're getting a major breakthrough in that area. You're healing. So there might be an area in your life that, though, no matter how much you work hard, you haven't seen the results. You haven't seen the Two of Cups. Again, your Two of Cups, where you're satisfied, you're fulfilled, right? You're working hard. And when you're satisfied and fulfilled, we are happy. but you haven't been feeling like that. You feel like you give, but you don't get it that back. But here, that's what is changing for you guys. Whatever you're giving, you're going to get it back. Again, 10 of coins. If you are someone who works really hard but doesn't get that much money, your heart and mind and soul is aligning, you're healing that area, and now you're going to get that much money back. You know, more money back. Like, that's what I'm getting here. For some others, you will be, I feel like you're finally releasing some sort of limited beliefs. And that's what is happening. You're healing, as I told you, you're healing completely. Your vibration is rising. Oh my God, group number three. You're progressing spiritually, there is no doubt. You're becoming one with divine. You're co-creating your dream life with the universe. I feel like you have given everything to the divine. And when we surrender everything to divine, magic happens. And that's exactly. Sometimes we think so much, oh, I have to do that, I have to control that. And now I feel like you're in this energy where you're like, today I'll do this. Tomorrow I'll do this because that's what I feel like. And I'm not going to do over because I feel that I have to control. You're letting go of. Like, this person is so hard to deal with. I'm giving it to divine. Divine, take care of this person. And I'm just going to do my best. I'm going to respond to situation. I'm not going to react. I'm just going to work on myself, divine. Rest, you take care of. And once we start living like that, everyday magic happens. And I'm completely getting goosebumps, guys. Okay, wow. Oh my God, a major breakthrough where you will be creating a legacy. You are the one who is going to be the first millionaire. I don't know, but that's what is coming. Interestingly, something you, oh God. Because really, once we give everything to divine, once we surrender, and that's what you're doing. You're right now in that energy of surrendering. Maybe you haven't completely surrendered, but you are going to do that. And what you're not seeing, because of this energy, you are aligning your body, mind, spirit, and you've been working on yourself, you've been working on something, and whatever you're working on, it's going to give you, it feels like you're giving one-fold and you're getting back tenfold. Maybe in the past you gave tenfold and you got one-fold, right? It's changing. Again, the 10 of coins, laughter, happiness. Your work is paying off. The struggles that you have gone through, finally it's paying off. For some of you, I see that what you're doing is like you're reprogramming your subconscious mind right now and you're healing. That's what is happening. Yes, a major breakthrough. Success is what I see for group number three. Spiritual progress as well. You're not only going to get the materialistic stuff. You're going to get that inner fulfillment, that peace. Oh, wow, nice. You're in high vibe. Your vibration is very high, very positive energy. Now let's see what else. My whole body, you know, I'm feeling something. I feel whoever is resonating, this is your message. And yes, I know that you will not be focused so much on timing because you are in that energy right now where you don't focus, you're not. You know that I don't have to focus when it will happen. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay in this vibration where I feel good with my body, with my soul, and I'm just going to do what's best for me. And I'm going to listen to my intuition every day. Yeah. Maybe you have not been watching that much tarot readings and all, I feel like, for some of you. Sometimes you just feel like that's why you come. I really feel like that. And maybe this is on your feed today, that's why you're watching. Anyways, let's see. Yeah, look, we have the Nine of Wands. You have been setting boundaries. You have been doing the work. You have been doing the toughest work. You have been setting boundaries with yourself. You have been setting boundaries with other people. You have been working on your people-pleasing behavior. You have been working on yourself, and it's tough sometimes. It's tough to get that discipline, but you have been doing the work. You have been, isn't it? And that's paying off. Look, we have the King of Pentacles and we have the Eight of Coins again. with this cow, there is good news regarding money, regarding your career, regarding, yeah, things are going to get balanced, your family life, your professional life, everything is balanced, you're getting the money, you are able to give your to your family. Yes, yeah, it feels like you're going to make a legacy. Wow. And for some of you, you're manifesting someone who is going to be really, really well off financially. And they want to provide for you. And that is also something I'm seeing here. Universe is gifting you a very, very abundant relationship. For some of you, this is about you, your work. But for others, it's like your marriage life is becoming very abundant. Maybe your spouse is getting a lot of money. Maybe you are getting a lot of money. But anyways, things are going to be very good, money-wise, financially, not only financially, you know, spiritually as well. That's the amazing thing. You know, because it feels like you are not someone who thought that if I have money, I'll be happy. No, no, no. You are someone who is happy in the present moment and being grateful. And that's why you're manifesting that. It feels like you are believing in magic. That's why you're seeing the magic happen. And that's exactly happening. Maybe you're not seeing that right now. Because you're in this healing phase, you're rejuvenating, yeah? And once it's complete, you know, healing is a process, but this thing, that this some sort of programmings that you had as you're releasing it, you're going to see the success. You are going to get it. Again, this deal or no deal, you're getting the first biggest prize, you know, how much money, the total, you know, you're winning the amount. That's what it feels like. So let's see. There's a final tarot card. Oh my god, that's a lot. Okay. Oops. Look, nine of coins. Look. Getting the kind of partner you want. Getting the kind of life you want. Your dream life. So your wishes are coming true. Feeling, look. She has all her cups and she's so relaxed now. She's not only she has gotten what she wanted. Now she's happy. She's peaceful there. She's not craving for more actually. She's not, oh, I got this now, on to the next. No. She's not doing that. I got that. I received that. I'm so thankful. I'm going to enjoy this. And then only I will slowly but surely, if I feel like doing, if I'm going to trust my intuition, and then I'm going to take the next step, right? It's not like that hush hush energy. I got this, next what? No. This is like feeling it, like get, you got this thing, now you're enjoying it, you're feeling so happy, you're feeling so grateful. Yeah, wow, beautiful guys. So let's see again, these smiles, look at the smile. You'll be smiling like this, happy, fulfilled. Maybe your wish is small, maybe you don't want that much of money, but whatever you're wishing for, it's going to happen and it will make you so happy. But one thing is right now what is happening is healing is happening. You're healing the past wounds, yeah. And sometimes these past wounds, when we don't heal, when we don't acknowledge that, it repeats, and you're acknowledging it, you're healing it, and now you're going to get that wish. For some of you, romance, a partner where you can be you, and look, deeply fulfilling relationship, deeply fulfilling career. That's what it feels like. So let's see what else. Oh wow, look, the garden and the gate, and we have the angel of love. You're listening to your heart again. Garden of the gate, you have been in this healing, like again, rejuvenation, and the garden of the gate. Sometimes we are so afraid of getting out of a comfort zone to make necessary changes. And with this garden and the gate, I see that you're making that necessary changes. You're disciplining your mind. You're putting boundaries. You're getting out of the gate. That's what I see. You have the keys now and you're getting out of the gate. And that's why you're going to see that rewards coming. So don't hold. And for some of you, this is an advice. Don't hold on to any habits that has stopped you. Listen to your intuition. Again, the key is your intuition. Trust that and take action. Yes. What you're not seeing is like your intuition is guiding you. You can hear your intuition very well. You're open to that thing, so trust that. Trust your heart, group number 3, and you will see the magic unfold. Let's see the final message here. Look, we have the Ace of Cups. Look at the nest here and the eggs here. For some of you, very, again, family. Look, family is safe. Family is secure. Yeah, you will be able to provide for your family, right? And again, with this Two of Cups, a new family. So yes, a nest that is safe, that is secure. You have this fulfillment. You're feeling happy. Your heart is full. Yeah. You're feeling safe. Yes, because once we start working with universe, we feel safe. We feel protected. And you will be feeling like that. Yes, I'm safe in my own body. I'm safe wherever I am because divine is protecting me. Your connection with divine is if you feel it's already there, it's going to be double. You will feel divine in everything that you do. You feel that divine presence. That's what I feel like here. Spiritually moving forward, spiritual progress I see. Your intuition is going to be very strong. And if you have any messages that you want to share with anyone, go ahead and do that as well, because it can help to, it can help with their life. Okay, so don't doubt your intuition here. So that's the beautiful message I received for you guys, group number 3. Hope it made sense. Hope it resonated. If it did, give me a thumbs up. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.